today I wanted to talk a little bit about a research project that I'm working on with a student of mine. We are looking at the bones of the skeleton, the humerus, the arm bone here, and we also have a femur, which is your thigh bone. The bones have traditionally been measured using the old-fashioned methods of calipers. We've got our osteometric board over here, and you can measure length, you can measure some aspects of shape. But in order to be able to see the internal structure of the bone, you have to actually do a destructive analysis, traditionally. And I worked on a project at the University of Tennessee where we did CT scans of the William M. Bass donated skeletal collection, which is a collection of modern humans. People have donated themselves to this facility. They actually decompose in a outside or outdoor research facility in natural conditions. So weathering, the rain, the snow, everything is affecting these skeletons. Some of them are buried. But what we end up with are a set of remains, skeletal remains, that can be investigated in sort of a backwards fashion. So we know their age, their weight, their sex, their cause of death often, and we can kind of work backwards to see, okay, well, what are the bones able to tell about that? And one of the things that I was interested in is body mass. So what do the bones tell us about body mass? Throughout our lives, we may not be aware of this, but our bones are constantly changing shape. And they change shape due to repetitive motions. You can develop arthritis in that way. But not just at the joints. It actually can change the shape of the shaft. And the more forces you're putting on in a compressive forces, so that would sort of be like gravity is a compressive force on the bones, as would be lifting up heavy weights or body mass. You need to increase the bone area or the bone will fracture. And so the bones have to constantly be remodeling in order to adapt to our changing habits throughout our lifetime. And so one of the things that we can then do is if we can look at that internal structure and we see how strong that cross section is and how much surface area there is, it actually tells us how the bone was being used. So we can work backwards. If we were to have a forensic case, for example, and we have a skeleton that's we find in the woods and we want to find out who this person was. So I'll turn this over to my student, Joe, who is using a program called Amira, and we have access to this impressive database of CT scans that are very high resolution, and we're using this program Amira that is able to create three-dimensional surface models of the bones, but we're doing external surfaces and internal surfaces so we can see that cross-section at any point in the bone without cutting the bone. And Amira it's a powerful program, very robust analyses, but it is cost prohibitive. So if there are any potential donors out there, we are looking for support because we're still working on the free trial version of Amira. And I'll let Joe show how impressive this program is and what we're able to do with it.
So we are using a program called Amira. And what it does is it takes the CT scan slices and lines them up so you can look at all of them in a row and you can see the bone. So what I do with the bone is I will line it up. You can see the structure of the bone inside and out. And from there, I will create a 3D model. I will choose which bones I want. And from there, the computer will compile all the slices of the CT scan and make it into a 3D model that you can rotate and look at from just about any angle that you want to, and observe any changes in the bone and any deformities, say, from stress on the bone. And from here, what we can do is measure the length of the bone and we can also find the area from each slice of the CT scan, and that will help us understand the density of the bone, and it goes slice by slice, so we can look at it and understand how thick the bone is at some areas. And from this, we can understand what has been affecting the bone and whether or not there's been any trauma to it, say, or if the person is overweight or does repetitive movements. So from that, we're using that to do about 40 skeletal remains, and we are looking at just the body mass index and how it relates to the bones.